Hi. So welcome to the first talk of retirement. I'm Umesh and I have a decade of experience in search. I was with Daily Hunt, second employee, 3.5 years. Then I was with back of 4.5 years, search engine platform. Moved to Lucidworks. For 6 months, you saw I did really like it. And now I am consulting for Unboxed 3 days a week. So this talk is an engineer's talk. I will demystify Lucene, I will demystify Solar, and I will tell, okay, where it works and where it is not. Okay. I have been a Lucene hacker for a while. So all this work, okay, slide is unboxed, but all the work has been done in Flipkart, okay, and we had a great team here. So about me, I have been using Lucene from 2.1 version. And I have been it, okay, it's 4.6, okay. The recent versions, I have looked at the Jiras, I have looked at what features have come in, but I have not really hacked it. User hacker, I have built middlewares, schema designer, all bunch of things, contributor, and I specialize in new use cases. So, the agenda, it is e-commerce search. And we are going to very specifically talk about near real-time search and building the near real-time index. Okay. The pipeline and everything I'm going to mention, but I'm not going to pay too much attention. That has been the topic which has been discussed all over. And I'm going to get into data structures, okay, and how to build your own inverted index and integrate with Lucene. So it is going to be a first principle approach, and then hopefully we'll have time for questions. So, this, okay, is a Flipkart page, okay. You have drill downs, you have 231 million documents, okay. It is a parent SKU and then it is a marketplace, so you have multiple listings for it. One thing I want to pay attention is, okay, this top position is a premium, okay. You have only 6 products, okay, that a user can see on a screen. Okay. I took this screenshot specifically for this purpose. Which means, okay, if I show an out of stock product there, I am losing real estate. Okay. And that is a decline in revenues. Okay. Nobody likes it. So, this is, okay, 2014, Big Billion Day. The problems we faced on that day, okay, led to us building this system that I want to describe. So, 24-hour sale, target of 100 million, achieved in 10 hours. Okay. What's the catch? I like Varkis Bidla, he's the founder of Lockdown. He puts very good jokes. Okay. So, 12,230. I was one of the guys, by the way, who couldn't buy anything. Okay. And okay, there was a BBD analysis, the links are there, you can see. But the real issues were, okay, these price changes and out of stock issues. Happened to a whole bunch of people, it spoiled the whole user experience. Okay. And there was a lot of backlash on social media. So this is what was actually happening on that day. Okay. 500 internals, offers which were expired, okay, and they were still showing up. Okay. Actually, you have products, okay, which are down, okay, which still have the offer. Okay. But as I say, it is the top product which matters. So the impression was, okay, all the products are gone. Okay, same thing. Okay. This is the steel wheel space. And this has, okay, people wondering. So, we took it back and said, okay, let's do Engineering 101. Okay, what is the real deal? Okay, because when something like this happens, okay, the issue is, okay, you should know your system, okay, where all the data is. Okay, how is this happening, okay, at what layer? So, this is what was happening. In a normal day, okay, the ranking is based on user intent and product. How good the product is. User intent, you can have implicit, historic behavior, session behavior, explicit like queries and filters that has been selected. And on the product, mostly you have how good the product is, and you have ratings and reviews and other things. Okay. The catalog items are there. So, but on sales day, okay, and people love, okay, how do you influence user behavior? One thing is, okay, user behavior, when you influence it, influence it through price or discount. Okay. So, I bought a TV, okay, 16,000 rupees, 40 inch TV. 8 months later, it's still used, okay? And I have been postponing the purchase for 2 years. Such a great deal. So instant gratification, price discount offers, and the delivery experience. This becomes the key things, okay, in a sales ranking. And if you want to get that right, okay, you have to reduce the data lag. Okay. And what's the data lag? So from source of truth, okay, you have the search index. And then from search index, the serials are getting shot to the front end. You have lag at both ends. From source of truth to search index and at the front end. So you have to reduce this data lag, okay, so that you can give a customer experience which is consistent. Now what are the sources of truth? So this is a Flipkart product case. You can see products and listings. Okay, there are a bunch of products. And you know, this is iPhone 6, okay, and you have multiple sellers for this. So this is the structure. Where did the data come from? Catalog service. And then these are the other sources. Availability comes from other service, seller rating service, promise service, offers, pricing service. Whatever you see over here, all the real crime attributes are coming from a different service. And all calls go to those services except from the search index. Everywhere, okay, all of these services actually get a call in real time, per request basis. So, now, data pipeline. So you have this source of truth. From there you have to send data to search index. Okay, and this is usually a pipe. Okay, it is not a per request basis. I'm specifically putting a big pipe. Streaming updates via push, Kafka plus system, that's a standard architecture. Caches, okay, front end, it's the search index. Okay, but then you have a cache, we have a Couchbase with TTR, and then we have a URL refresher, okay, which challenges in these URLs. Okay. So this is something, okay, which is standard Lambda architecture. You know. There are a lot of talks, okay, I'm not going to talk about it. My focus is search index. Now, Lucene, okay, we say Solr Elasticsearch, at the end, okay, it is just Lucene. And Lucene is just a plain inverted index, okay, with a lot of other things. So we know Hadoop ecosystem pretty well. Okay, we know SDFS is there, okay, which is the storage system, HBase, MapReduce, Hive. Okay, we know how all this ecosystem fits. In Lucene, all of that, okay, is there, but it is hidden. Okay, so for storage, you have directory implementation. Okay, you have RAM directory, you have SDFS, you have MMap, and for data serialization, okay, you have Codex. This came in Lucene Codex. Okay, so you have Bitstits. Okay, which is basically posting this. You have a codec for that. You have a bunch of implementation. Similarly, you have column-oriented fields, which is doc values. Okay. Then you have stored fields, you have term vectors, and then you have a whole bunch of other fields. Okay. So this is the reality. Okay. These things are there. Okay, they are pluggable. Okay. Especially since 4x. Okay. There's a whole reason, okay, why it was done. But majorly it was because people are not using this for research purposes. Or it was done. So, now I have list a whole bunch of lists of Lucene resources that will be very useful for somebody who wants to demystify Lucene and understand it from the first principles. Of course, Dog Cutting was the creator. He created a group later. Okay, Dutch, I think. Okay. And he has a paper, Search Optimization in Total Ranking. Okay. Lucene is based on that paper. Galeen, Lucene's, this is LinkedIn's search architecture. It is similar to what we have built, okay, but different, of course, is for their use case. Okay, that talks, okay, demystifies Lucene. Then Early Bird, okay, it was by Michael Bush. This real-time search at Twitter, okay, this is what I was targeting, okay, when we were building this. And then you have, like, okay, books and this, so just resources. Okay, on the blog side, you have a, okay, McCandless is a very good blog. Okay, and then, okay, if you want to look into inside a Lucene index, okay, the best tool is Luke. Okay, so I have used Luke a lot. To learn about Lucene and how indexing, analysis and everything works. So, okay, I'm going to skip this. So, the final takeaway that I want everybody to take here, okay. Search index, okay, we built a custom NRT index and plugged it, okay, with Lucene base index. Okay. Essentially what we have built, okay, is term sharded index, and I'm going to teach you how we built it. Integrated Lucene query engine through callbacks, okay, and it has better liveliness than Solr Cloud. Solr Cloud, okay, is not real. So why not use the source of truth doing internet ranking? So a lot of people just hit the calls, hit the service and get what is the availability. The thing is, okay, 234K SKUs may have seen the top. Okay, that's for that one request, okay. I can't make 234K calls to Promise Engine or any of the service, okay, to get the ranks. So these are basically type loop calls. You have network latency, it will kill the downstream service. You have to have all this data, okay, streamed to you. Solar Cloud, brief about it. It is IoT based sharding. In Lucene, update is not support, partial update is not supported. What you have is update is delete plus add. And then we use something called joint block join index for parent-child documents, which means you update basically the whole block. So, and that puts additional complication. Okay, what happens is Solar Cloud, you send a request document and it gets streamed to all replicas, which means, okay, you have a contention between indexing and search. It doesn't work actually. So, I'm not going to discuss much more. Okay. Support, independent field updates, support is not there. Single point of failure or bottleneck, okay, is not, but there is still a single point of failure. Okay. And then you have, it is not a horizontal scalable service. If you have QPS, lots of replicas, it is going to bog down indexing. It is going to be very slow. And there are talks, okay, there is a very good papers. There are use cases, okay, it has been benchmarked. So you can refer to online on those. So e-commerce marketplace. So we said, okay, what are the special data characteristics of the e-commerce marketplace? So this is basically it. So you have product, SKU, this is parent document, and you have listing, this is child document, which is basically, you know, it takes all attributes of parent document plus adds some more. Query is mostly SKU attributes, okay, like brand, filter, color, and blah, blah, okay, title, all of those. Filters can be your SKU attributes, and plus let's listing attributes, let's say price, okay, or seller ratings, okay, or delivery times. Okay. And ranking, okay, is SKU plus listing attributes. Okay. Listing plays a lot of role, okay, in the ranking side, especially on our sales team. And this is the update rate, by the way. So on pricing, okay, the red ones, okay, are the ones which are highly, they get very high updates at the peak time. Pricing, you get like 10 million updates in an hour. Okay. Offers also like 10 million updates in an hour because the whole catalog changes. Okay. Okay. It's just a whole bunch of tags. Okay. And combining all of them together, okay, into a single pipeline really doesn't work. So the bottleneck is your document mail, okay, where you're getting all of these guys, okay, and then trying to create a mega document, okay, and then sending it to the scene. So, document builders becomes the bottleneck. And what happens inside Lucene, okay, inside Lucene, okay, it's called segment merges. So, Lucene has lots of mini indexes, okay. So, you know, that kills the performance. I'm skipping these ones, okay. So, what we tried, okay, by the way, okay, basic about Lucene segment, okay. It is a standalone index by itself, okay, with all complete data structures. So, and what happens is it is immutable, okay, which means, okay, once you have got it, okay, you can take out the mappings and try to manipulate by yourself. Okay. So this is what we tried. Okay, take the segment mappings out. We said, okay, in the segment, what's the primary key? You have external key. What's the internal document ID? Okay. And then, okay, you take a callback, okay, and then say, okay, take this mapping out, okay, and try to manipulate it outside. We also tried Lucene codecs, okay, the ones I talked, okay. It didn't work. The encoder, decoder that Lucene supports, and you can plug it, okay, we tried that, okay, and we tried it building that, you know, in Redis, it didn't work, okay, because it had issues with two-phase coming. So, what I have summarized is about, okay, 1 year of work, okay, right now, okay, the three approaches. So, standard talk code, okay, didn't work, okay, you can't convince management, by the way, okay, with this. So we tried the first one. Okay, so it was like, okay, we were prototyping, seeing, okay, for 4 months, 3 months, okay, seeing it, okay, benchmarking it, okay, and it didn't work. Okay. So, the final one, okay, and is what basically agile method. Okay. So we sat down together and said, okay, now we tried the whole consistent approach. By the way, till this time we were trying all consistent approach, okay, between inverted index, ranking, filtering, everything. It didn't work. So we went back and looked at the drawing board. So again, back to over here. So this is the e-commerce marketplace. Okay, we started looking at what are the critical factors over here. So seller marketplace, okay, you know, query, SKU attributes. So whatever is in green, okay, are the ones, okay, which are low changing things. Whatever is in red, okay, they are very highly changing things. So we said, let's just break it. Okay. This is what Twitter has done, by the way. Not Twitter, okay. This is what LinkedIn has done. Okay. Okay. So, of course, we came to load what are data. So it is a base index, it's a normal Lucene index. It gives text relevance, it gives all meta fields, and all NFR, so basically all product ratings, everything. It has lower rate of change, okay, and whenever you want to update it, okay, you go and read the full document. The NRT store is what we built. So the requirements for it, okay, must have a streaming updates. Should be, and all servers, okay, that are going to get updates are serving live traffic. It has to be commitless, okay, there cannot be a delay, because any time you do a commit, okay, there is going to be a delay. Remove single point of failure or bottlenecks. Support burst upgrades, okay, because at the peak time, okay, you have to get like 120. We got 120 key updates, okay, I'm going to talk about that later, in a second. Okay, it took that. And it has to be optimized for ranking. Okay, we sacrifice on filtering, okay, which is another use case for e-commerce, it has to be optimized for ranking. Sub numbers, end-to-end lag, less than 10 seconds, 100k updates per second, hundreds of independent sources or signals, okay, and okay, I talked about this. So, okay, so again I talked about this, so commitless, okay, why? Because Solar has internal caches, basically this boils down to that, and there is a lot of garbage creation, okay. But it doesn't scale. Okay. If you want very good performance, okay, your caches have to work. Okay, there is a whole bunch of overhead, okay, that goes with coming. So now this is the real talk. Okay. Till there, okay, it was building context. Demystifying NRT store. So what are the stores? Okay, what when you are talking about an inverted index, okay, what are the things that inverted index must have? Two things. One, a forward index, which is basically a list of talk values, Lucene terms. Okay, it is just, okay, you just go as for this key or this document number, give me the value. Okay. And an inverted index, okay, for this term, okay, give me the all list of all matching documents. So the first is a forward index. Second, okay, is an inverted index. And okay, what really happens is, okay, you get the forward full document, okay, and then you convert from there again, you make it to the inverted index. Okay, that's what really happens, okay, that's what all Lucene does, okay, in the index writer. Okay. It does it in a scalable way. There's a whole bunch of things over there. So, what is the forward index? So, basically, it's just a column of stories. Okay. So, and optimized for highly update rates. Okay. So, you have, you know, all data structures are memory resident here. Okay, so we basically use arrays and bit sets and HAR, not sparse bit sets. I'm going to talk about them. And there is a whole bunch of work which has been done here. CS store was the first store to have a columnar storage. And Lucene supports doc values, which are basically just ORC, mini ORC or per K if you are familiar with the Hadoop world. Considerations. Lookup efficiency. 50% percentile, we have 10k matches, 99% percentile, 1 million matches. Has to be on Java heap. And which means, okay, all data sources have to be memory efficient. So this is the API. So it is given the primary string, okay, give me the value, okay, where value can be your numeric, float, double, string, whatever. Okay. And it gets called in nested loops. Okay. So the callback goes like, okay, for each matching document, for each field that participates in the scoring, okay, give me the value. Okay. So you have 1 million documents, okay, and 20 fields, let's say, okay, it is going to say 1 million into 20 fields, okay, give me the value. Okay. So actually it is, we have much more than 20 fields, okay, and it is nested calls. Okay. And then you apply a whole bunch of complicated functions, maybe, okay, you can have any mathematical function. It is all function queries, so any mathematical function is supported. So very, very, it has to be very, very lookup efficient. Okay. So the new implementation, okay, hash paper. You just want value, right? So given a string key, okay, just want the value. So use a hash map. So you have a product ID, okay, say product A, okay, and you have ID, say true or false. Okay. And then your lookup engine says, okay, no. So you get a callback, document ID, some internal Lucene instrument document ID, and say field price, give it the value. So you go and look at the Lucene instrument, okay, what's the primary key for document? Okay. Say this product A. And then you say, okay, fine, okay, let me go and look at it. So, yeah, sure. So product ID 3, what's the, so basically here, so this is document ID 3, okay, you have the field price, okay, you want the value for this, this is a callback from Lucene, you have to look up the engine, say product ID for 3, what's the product ID for 3, so you are looking in this segment, say product ID is product D, and then you are going to look at this hash map, say product ID D, price, okay, what's the price, this two. So you got the answer, okay, what's the cost? So it is 10 seconds for 1 million lookups, okay, which is definitely unacceptable for a single field, okay, because we have to get response in an address, okay, maybe less. So what's the bottleneck, okay, and we do the JFR over here, but we benchmarked it, okay. And okay, the thing is, okay, is the integer odd which Lucene is giving, then we are converting into a string. Okay. So that conversion generates garbage, it is not efficient. Okay. And in application layer, okay, we are taking this string, converting into hash code, okay, and then from hash code, you can, how your hash function works. Okay, you have a bucket, and then okay, it is a very large hash map. Okay, only one person, one request will. There are not going to be any cache locality. So, the whole thing actually, you know, because of integer to string, string to integer, okay, and then look and find the bucket, okay, that whole thing is inefficient, okay, and we said, okay, just remove it. So, we just removed that, okay, and came up with the second solution. So, we said, okay, lookup engine is also based on odd. And we are going to say primary key to integer odd. Okay. This is an NRT dictionary which is maintained. Okay. So, at update path, okay, find the odd, update the values for odd, and then just, you know, it makes your prime. It just works because, okay, Lucene does it already. And at the lookup path, okay, you say Lucene has an internal document ID. And I'm going to maintain, okay, what does that internal document ID for a particular segment maps in an NRT store. So basically, what happens is, this is something that should be, Lucene segment, inside a Lucene segment, okay, your product ID is going to change. So your ordinal is going to change. Okay, because, there's nothing like global, okay, it is the product's or in that segment. Okay, it is internal Lucene, Lucene is not, actually it recommends you should not use it outside. Okay. So it is going to change. Okay. But for us, okay, in the NRT forwarder store, it is not going to change. Okay. Because there, whatever ID get a product gets, okay, there it is going to stay constant. Which makes it easy for updates. So we do a mapping. Okay. So we have a doc ID to NRT ID. Okay. We do a mapping. Okay. And document product ID B is 0 in Lucene segment, okay, but it is 3, okay. It is 3 over here, this is product B, 0 over here, okay, and over here, okay, it is 3. So we have this mapping, 0 maps to 3. Okay. And then at the callback time, okay. So, sure, okay. So you maintain a basically, at the callback time, okay, we are going to just take this, okay, look into this doc ID to an RT ID, get the document, okay, and then just go and pick the value. Okay. How much is the performance? It is actually 100 MS. So data structures. The data structures. Okay. So I'm I have done a comparison with Lucene Index. Okay, you have a term dictionary Lucene Index, and you have posting list, okay, which is basically with sparse bit sets, okay, and then you have dot values. In case of our, okay, all these data structures are type field. Okay. So basically, if it is a Boolean field, let's say availability, okay, or whether a product is live or something, it is a fixed bit set. Okay. So with dense bit sets, so it is very fast to update. Okay, it is fast to look up. Okay, so and then this is basically this random updatable and searchable. If it is enumerated field, okay, and with low cardinality, it is a list of fixed bit sets. With high cardinality field, it is a byte array. Okay. Numeric fields, okay, array. Similarly, okay, tag. If it is a tag field, okay, you maintain a dictionary, and then you have you are maintaining another bit set, sparse bit set. So, okay, sorry, okay, this slide should have been earlier. So basically, I am going to. So this is document ID 3. This is price. Lookup engine said, okay, give me the price for this. What is the NRT ID for 3? And it says 2. Okay. And then, okay, you look up, say, what is the price for 2? So I was looking for this slide. So this is 100 MS. Okay. And this is a 100x difference, okay, in performance. Okay. Just by changing, using the right data structures, right, and understanding your use case. And that allowed us to build a whole bunch of things. Inverted index. Okay. So you have the requirements is, okay, that you have one term, okay, and you have to give a whole bunch of list of matching documents. So and the way to do it, okay, so we chose, okay, over here, we couldn't keep it consistent. It was like, okay, maintaining an inverted index, okay, is modifying an inverted index is tough, okay, because this is a sparse bit sets, and sparse bit sets will occupy a whole bunch of memory if you are going to use an array or a Boolean bit. So Lucene does a whole bunch of data structure. It uses runline coding, it uses other bunch of storage efficiency, okay, to reduce the space and make it more efficient, but make it faster. Okay. So you can't update it. So what we do is, okay, we periodically invert it. Okay. And there is a lag. Okay. So what you have over here is, okay, this is a Lucene segment. Okay, 0 is product ID B, 1 is product A, 2 is product C, 3 is product B. And then you have this NRT forward store. Okay. What you do is, okay, you take this die over here, okay. Let's say it's availability 2, okay. You say, okay, 0 and 3, okay. So this is we do it periodically, and then we use something called NRT filter. This is, all of this is basically callbacks in Lucene, okay. You are providing implementation, okay, which reads from your data. So you, there is an NRT inverter, okay, which just reads this, okay, and creates this posting list. And then you use that, okay, to your custom class in club plugin, okay, which is your NRT filter. So the final solution, okay, we use Lucene extensions, we integrated with it with custom inverter index, okay, and okay, we have an eventual consistency between replicas, because all replicas are reading from Kafka, okay, and there is no consistency between them, okay, for amount of time. And the reason we did that, we wanted a better liveliness, we wanted a better indexing throughput, and we wanted a consistent latency, okay, between such things. So these are the solar integration points. Value sources, filtering, we have a custom filter. Query, we have a query which is wrapped over filter. And of course, we had to write a whole bunch of custom components, setting, collectors, and all of them. Okay. So people who are familiar with, I have kept this slide, okay, if somebody is familiar with solar, and it actually worked out. This is the whole architecture. You have a JSON pipeline, okay, and then, okay, you have all the services, okay, catalog, price, availability, offers, okay. All of that feeds into Kafka. So basically, catalog feeds into Kafka, ingestion pipeline, and goes to scene of this. So basically, and goes to Solar Master. And then, what you have is some of these, okay, pricing, availability, offer, seller quality, okay, these get feed into Kafka, okay, over here. And that goes through an RTF. Redis is just for source of truth. This is a bottleneck, by the way. Okay. They're trying to move this. Okay. I think they might have already moved it. And it is for use for bootstrapping, new solar slim. And then you have an RT forward index, an RT inverted index store. And then you have all these components, ranking, faceting, okay, which all plug into this NRT forward store, okay, and inverted store. And then, okay, it goes to this integrated. Solar Master, you have a commit plus replicate plus reopen, this whole cycle goes. And, okay, over here, this is all inside a replica, by the way. All of this, okay, that you see is a single solar replica. Okay. It all memory is in data systems. So we have a specification and then we have implemented. So this is the experience. Okay. This is last year, 2016. Okay. And I'm sure, okay, there were no out of stocks. Okay. People can tell, okay, I was too busy doing something, looking at the figures. So this is the accomplishment. Real-time sorting, real-time filtering using post filters, higher latency, near real-time filtering using by you generally basically take this the forward index and you revert it. So no consistency between lookup and filtering. If you say select out of stock, okay, it will show you out of stock. It may show you out of stock, and it is independent of lucene commits, okay, which is a very big win. And query latency comparable to Docker. Consistent length. So this is 150 signals. This with the part we are using it for 150 signals. Auto start products went down by 2x. And 50k updates. Okay, that was the what was on the big billion day. We benchmarked it for. Any questions? Sorry. I'm sorry, it was a, usually this is a bigger talk.
There's a question down the front, please.
Hey, hi. Can you hear? You talk, you said that you went commitless.
Yes.
For solar, right? So how do you deal with system crashes and all? Suppose an entire cluster goes down, you are not committing at all, is it?
No, see, there are 1000 replicas.
Yeah.
Okay, and the data is in Kafka. You can just replay from Kafka.
Okay? So you
so in, entire cluster doesn't go down, right? It is one box, okay, has issue or something.
Yeah, but in a case that an entire cluster goes down, so how many nodes are there? Like suppose 100 nodes are there, right?
Yes. So the source of truth is Kafka.
Okay.
Okay. So replicas, okay, has just and then okay, the snapshot, okay, is in Redis. Okay. So you read from Redis, okay, generate this inverted, build this data structure, okay, and okay, you replay Kafka.
Okay.
Okay. So we have trouble if Redis goes wrong.
Okay.
Okay. That has, if you let's say have a bootstrapping, let's say 20 nodes or 30 nodes, 50 nodes, okay, everybody hitting Redis, okay, at the same time, okay, actually this cluster restart, okay, which is an issue. If you are going to do a cluster restart, okay, 100 nodes, okay, then it, but then you don't never do a cluster restart. It is always a rolling deployment, okay, rolling restart. Okay, so that works out.
Next question, please.
Another thing is, okay, the NRT portion is the committless one. The index, okay, the text based index is still committed. Oh, it is just short for near real time.
Alright, okay. How do you really avoid commits? Because at some point you have to commit and you have to put the do you avoid some?
No, not on the, see, there, it is term sharded. So some fields, all the cortex fields, okay, are on disk. They are losing disk. Okay? So you have commits, okay, and you have backups, and you have restore and everything. You have the whole DR there. The pricing, availability, you know, other fields, okay, which are very fast changing, okay, there, okay, it is not coming. Okay, it is in memory index, okay, it is generated through Kafka. So the data source of truth is Kafka. Okay, and then you have snapshot at Redis. So you can generate it very fast. Okay, it takes maybe 10-15 minutes of it.
So cluster sizing, what is the cluster size? And how much ability you need?
Yes. So the sparse bit sets do not need much memory. So one example I will give you. Okay, we were by mistake we had enabled this, you know, a dense bit set, 2 GB and 22 MB. Okay, so that's what the space savings the sparse bit sets give you.
And I think
and then we have encoded byte array. We use byte arrays. Okay, ourselves. Okay, we don't use.
I think everyone was trying to understand it really hard. I was trying to understand really hard what actually has happened, but I have missed a lot of the.
Yeah, I'm planning to put it on GitHub, okay, tutorial based, okay, that this is the build inverted index, okay, from first principles, okay, plug it in. Yeah, Umesh Prasad.
Alright, are there any final questions? No other questions, alright, thank you very much. I'd like to take a minute to introduce the